New York City's Upper East Side, a mecca for elite private school education in America. And for parents seeking the fast track to the Ivy League for their kids, there's no better place than the Dalton School. At nearly $55,000 a year, Dalton parents leave nothing to chance, which is why many parents say they were outraged to learn last fall of the school's decision to teach sex ed, including masturbation, through a cartoon to kids as young as six.
It's okay to touch yourself and see how different body parts feel.
I didn't learn about that till I was, I think, I don't know, 12, 13?
Six is definitely too young.
The class, taught by health and wellness educator Justine Angfante, sparking new outrage this week after the New York Post revealed the educator recently led a porn literacy workshop at another elite prep school.
Parents have to be more involved, although in Dalton, I assume they are because of how much they spend.
According to the Post, children here at Dalton are also taught lessons on consent, something the Post says many parents here feel was never given by them to the school when it comes to teaching their kids about sex ed. "We are furious," one Dalton mother told the Post. "We were horrified to learn this was shown to our first grade 6- and 7-year-old kids without our knowledge or consent."
Timing is everything.
Psychotherapist Dr. Robbie Ludwig says young children simply aren't emotionally ready to learn about sex acts.
Bringing something up like masturbation too early can be confusing, and if not managed correctly, could get kids curious in a way that doesn't serve them well. Surfing the web, being vulnerable to predators out there.
Despite growing concerns among parents at Dalton regarding its increasingly woke education, none are willing to go on the record to voice their disapproval. We reached out to Dalton for comment on this story, but have not yet heard back. Parents who spoke to the Post did so anonymously. And while Newsmax made several attempts to reach out to parents ourselves, we couldn't find a single one who would go on camera. For Newsmax, Mike Carter, New York.